Hello, Act Up North. Bit of a change of... Well, I say a change of scenery. It's still in my room, but just not sat at the desk, which is where I normally am sat. I saw the bed and it was all made and I'm tired, so I thought I'll start on the bed. That means I don't have to walk the three paces to get to the bed when I'm finished. This week was, I'll try not to shake the camera too much, so do forgive. Wow. Let there be light. This week we had a very special guest tutor in the form of Judy Holt. I hope I got that right. You know me in names. I'm awful. I'm really bad. In fact, I'm going to double check that. Yes, Judy Holt. I did get it right. Yes. Get in there. And she was our wonderful guest tutor for this evening. And we also had Corrie, lovely Corrie Grace, our class tonight. I'm sorry I didn't recognise you at first. Nobody would know if I didn't tell you this, is that when I rang the buzzer to come into the Liverpool classes this evening, Corrie was the one who buzzed me in, and I got up the stairs and all I saw was this woman standing at the top of the stairs just smiling at me. I was just like, hi. It's just like, and she kept smiling at me and I thought, right, okay, I'm a little bit weirded out now. And then she went, it's Corrie. And I was just like, oh my God, she's had her hair cut. And I must have just looked like an idiot just standing there just looking at her really inanely just going, I realised I had exactly the same problem when I got my hair cut. When I first ever got my hair cut, really, really short. It's like people that I'd known for many, many years, like the first time I'd seen them in a while, and they just look at you as if to say, I know you from somewhere. Not entirely sure where though. And you'd be like, we sort of, yeah, friends for years and years, you don't remember. Oh, yes, Alice, now I remember you. So that was a bit, so that was a weird thing. I'm so sorry, Corrie, for not recognising you. Very nice haircut though, very good. Sorry, let me just make myself more comfortable and shake the camera some more. So this one was looking particularly at working for camera and about maximising your potential as a performer and sort of how to make the most of the opportunity presented to you by an interview or by an audition. So that was an interesting premise, I've got to say, because I wouldn't know what to do if I got into an audition. I think I'd really balls it up, to be quite honest. So I was really, from the outset, very, very fascinated by this. It started off with some very, very basic just relaxation exercise, you know, just shaking it all out and, you know, really loosening up your neck and your shoulders and your face is really important to sort of warm up your face. I know it sounds ridiculous. I'd never actually thought about warming up my face before. But it just makes sense if... It makes sense now, yes, but at the time it was just like, wait, what? So I'm actually going to pick it up, the camera, because I keep shaking the bed and it's just like, you'll just have to put up with my really shaky camera work while I slowly fall asleep in front of you. So after the relaxation exercises, it was a short paired exercise. I was with Jess for this one. And we'd sit opposite each other as I'm sat opposite the camera now, and we would tell each other a story of something that's happened to us very recently. And when you watch that person, you took on their mannerisms. Now, I know because I'm holding the camera, I can't really show you, but you'd have definitely seen it before. Like, I talk a lot with my hands. I'm a very, usually, although I'm not at the moment, knackered at the moment. So, I'm normally a very animated person, and I do a lot of hand gestures when I'm telling a story. And what happened was after you told each other the story, you then had to tell a story back to them, and you had to mimic the other person. Now, for me personally, I was very paranoid about it descending into parody, because it's one thing to try and be the other person, but you don't want to take the piss, do you? It depends on the context, but in this particular exercise. So that was... Oh, bless you! Somebody sneezing outside. That's nice. So I was very, very paranoid about it descending into parody, but I don't think either of us did. Are you okay out there? Sounds like someone's dying of the plague out there. So, getting back to what I was talking about. So I was paranoid about that particular problem. But I think Jess did a wonderful impression of me. It was really interesting. It was like having a conversation with myself. Now, I know I normally have conversations with myself. As my wall over there says. Yes, I talk to myself. Sometimes I need expert advice. But, you know, it's bizarre when you're seeing somebody who is mimicking your body language. And I always knew that I spoke with my hands, but I think what was also fascinating with Jess was that she picked up on my vocabulary as well, which was really, it was a really nice touch. She wasn't just telling the story back at me, just using the bare bone facts. She was going, oh, you use the phrase, like crumple, like tinfoil. And you use all these lovely descriptive words, and she put those into her performance, and that was just, it was beautiful to watch. It was really nice and very flattering. So thank you very much for that, Jess. And it was an exercise in people watching. As an actor, you have to be able to watch other people, and you have to be able to observe. You know, it's not just enough to go out there and go, oh yes, people milling about being people, doing people-y things. You know, you have to be able to watch individuals, and you have to be able to see what makes them tick, you know, sometimes literally. So that was, it was a wonderful, wonderful exercise. Moving on from that, we went on to do a group exercise, which was scripted. And this further facilitated not only in our pairs that we were still placed into, although I moved on from Jess to work with Lauren, one of our newer members of our Tuesday Liverpool group, and we got to talk about what we thought was going on in the script, what we thought the characters sort of, you know, motivations were, and what their main objectives were in, throughout the scene, and who they were as people. And it's just, it was mentioned, the idea of a sort of character questionnaire, and so I can't remember who asked this question, I'm so sorry. This came right at the end, after the I'll go in chronological order, otherwise I'll just confuse myself. once we went through these scenes a couple of times, we were invited to perform them for the class, but the class could sit wherever they wanted. It wasn't sort of like, you know, you stay there, you audience, me performer. They could place themselves, to use some zany camera work, wherever they wanted. So if somebody wanted to, like, sit right on top of you and watched you as you performed, that'd be fine, because, you know, the same could be done with a camera. So, I'm done messing about with this thing now, I promise. So it was really interesting. I didn't find it off-putting. I thought I would find it off-putting. I thought it would really freak me out if somebody sort of sat right there. I'd be like, hello. But you can't do that if you're on set, because you're more than likely at some point in your career going to end up with a camera wanting to become one with one side of your face. But it wasn't an uncomfortable experience. It was really, really fascinating. And when you got to sit, it was... and watch other people perform. It was interesting to see where everybody sat and what people thought would be an interesting angle to watch a particular scene from. And, of course, the comments were always fabulously positive and just... You know, reaffirming that we are all on the right track. Nobody's abysmal here, I think. Not so sure about me. It's always the way when I perform. It's like when I see other people perform, I go, oh God, that's really good. And then I feel like I'm performing and I feel like I'm a cardboard cut out of myself. I don't know if anybody else ever feels that way when they perform. It doesn't feel that way when you're rehearsing. When you're rehearsing it feels like you're just being you. But when you perform something, it's just like, I suddenly don't feel like a real person anymore, and I think it'll get better, but sometimes I do feel a little bit stunted and wooden, and in some cases rather emotionally detached from the scene. I think it really depends on the piece that I'm given, or how much... freedom or free reign that I feel that I've got with a particular character. But on this particular occasion, I think Lauren handled it absolutely famously. But yeah, I felt like I was a bit like a cardboard cutout version of myself. It was just I was having an out of scene experience. Looking down upon myself, going, "What the hell are you doing?" So that was my experience. Wasn't a bad experience, but could try harder is what I would have put on my own report card for that one. And then to round up, Judy briefly went through the idea of an actor's questionnaire. This was mentioned right at the beginning of the class. And these are a series of questions that you not only ask your characters that you're about to play, they're apparently questions that you can also ask yourself as a performer. It's the theory that you will be cast to type, which is great, but sometimes I sort of... Recently it's got me looking in the mirror going, posh... articulate, sort of, really, how many roles am I getting here? That's exactly what I'm thinking about myself sometimes when I look at myself. I'm just like, this is not going to work. But, you know, it's the idea that you will get, not typecast, but you will have a type and you will be cast to it. And people will be looking at you not just for how you look as a person, but for how you behave and, you know, little things like, not just, oh God, seriously, I promised somebody that I'd send them a list if they went through that with us. Judy went through the list in one, I swear she didn't breathe, but she went through this entire list right at the end of the class. There was no way on earth any of us could have possibly have written it down, or even just got any of it down, so I'm going to try and get it all in here, and I'll email you the link to this video to show that I tried. But it was the idea of not just what your, you know, the basics, you know, name, age, you know, gender, you know, what's your main objective, so on and so forth. Those are the basics that we all cover. But really in-depth stuff, which may not ever be actually covered in the scene that you're doing. All kinds of things, like, you know, do you have children? What's the best thing you've ever done? What's the worst thing you've ever done? You know, your personality type. What makes you smile? What disgusts you? You know, other things like how sexually experienced you are. Just really, really, just tons and tons of really bizarre stuff to ask your character and to ask yourself. Because when you know yourself as an actor, as a person, you'll be able to know the types of characters that you'll be capable of playing. I think I grabbed the right end of the stick with that one. Feel free to correct me if I haven't. So I would actually like to see this list, because apparently, Peter, if you ever see this, apparently you have a copy of this list, and it was given out when these classes first started. I've never actually seen this list because I'm really naughty, and I didn't know you existed until May of last year, and I never actually got to see it. So, if possible, is there any way we could see this list? Because it looks like a really fascinating list, and as she was going through it, it was just like, I'd never thought of asking one half of the questions that were on this list, and I cannot possibly remember them all. I think, if anything, it reminds me of the kinds of things that I was asked. I would have been asked when I was doing my writing at university, believe it or not. And when you're creating characters, you are asked to ask all kinds of questions of the characters that you're creating. And I think it's a very similar process in that respect. And I think it's the first parallel that I've ever found between the acting and the performing. So I was really happy when I heard that, because I thought, oh, it's not a completely alien concept. But the questions are slightly different because they're geared towards the performance of your character and not who they are. Well, a lot of it is about who they are deep down inside and what's going up on here and in here. But, you know, I think sometimes in writing you have to focus on the internal world, and this also focuses on the external existence of the characters that you portray as well. So I would like to see that list. If there was any way I could see that list, that would be wonderful. I would love you forever. What a strange thing to promise. So, so that was, I think, oh God, I've rambled so much, it's nearly 20 minutes. I'm sorry about all the ums and ahs and oh gods, I've had 4.5 hours sleep. I am, as always, knackered. I don't know what it is about Tuesdays. I sleep so well every other day of the week. And I think it's excitement, you know. I think I wake up about 4 o'clock in the morning every Tuesday morning because I'm just like, oh, acting today. And it's just like, it's 4 in the morning. Go to sleep. And my brain's just like, no, get up and do it now. My brain's just like, do that thing you do. Do that, do something. Do that acting thing you do. And it's just like, it's 4 in the morning, brain. Please go to sleep. And it's just like, nah. My brain turns into a very, very knocked off 5-year-old when it gets excited, bless it. But the rest of me is still 28 and tired. So, yes, I really need to go to sleep right now. So I'm sorry about the quality of this video. I'm sorry it's not my usual wonderful verbose self, but yeah, I am gonna go away now. It was wonderful to have Judy with us, and Corrie as well. Thank you to everybody who worked with me in this particular, what is it, class. That's the word I'm looking for. God, I really am grinding to a halt now. Thank you to everybody who worked with me this week. Thank you to everybody who didn't work with me this week, but entertained me massively with your wonderful performing. And I will see you all next week.